Hey guys, welcome to the channel, and today I'll show you how you can convert your web app or website into a mobile app. So let's get started. So as you can see, I have this Notes app and I have built it in Next.js. You can see the source code here, right? And in this app, I can just add notes, etc., and delete them. Now this is running inside a web browser. Let's try to run this inside an iOS simulator. So for that, we are going to be using a tool called Capacitor. Let's install it into the project. So I'm just gonna go here, create a new terminal, right? So npx, not npx, but npm install at capacitor/cli and capacitor4, right? Hit enter, and this will install the packages. Now we need to install platforms like mobile platforms, for example, Android and iOS. For that, Capacitor again provides their own packages. So iOS and Android, hit enter, it will install the packages. Now we have to create our Capacitor config. For that, we just have to do npx cap init. And it will basically ask you a couple of questions. What should be the name of your app? I'll just say Notes app. And then it will ask me for a bundle ID or package ID, which is basically, you know, the unique ID of your app across the App Store, Play Store, right? I'm just gonna say com.notes.app, hit enter, and it successfully created a capacitor.config.ts. Now, here I only have to go type server and type URL, right? And in this, you can put your website URL, right? Like whatever it is, something.com, example.com, whatever. But right now I'm running it on a local. So I'm just gonna put localhost 3000. And this is where this app will point to, right? And that this is pretty much it. Now I just go here and I'll say npx cap add iOS, that is basically, you know, add the iOS code into this web app, and I'll just hit enter, npx cap add iOS. You can see, you know, it's installing native dependencies, right? And you can see the iOS folder here, right? Now you can see the iOS folder, right? And now let's try to run this inside a simulator. I'll just say npx cap open iOS. Now keep in mind, you need to have Xcode installed into your system to be able to run this. So install Xcode before doing this, and you hit enter, it will open the Xcode workspace. So it's opening. You can see the Xcode workspace, and I just have to go ahead and, you know, select the emulator. So I have selected iPhone 16 Pro here and just click run, and it will try to run our app inside a simulator. So it's building the app, you can see here. Open the simulator, and you can see the app open. Now let's see if it will be able to load our web app. And as you can see, our web app is now a mobile app, right? And I can use it normally the way I was using it before, this, add, whatever, right? So, and I can delete and all that. And this is basically how you'll do it. And you can convert this URL into anything. So once you go live, for example, you upload this app to Play Store or whatever. And before doing that, just change this URL to point to any HTTP URL, and the app will point to that URL. But don't go just now. I will also show you how you can use and access native functionality right from inside your app. All right. So the native functionality that we are implementing today is taking a photo from the camera app. So let's do that. For that, you need to install a native plugin from Capacitor. So let's do that. npm install at capacitor/camera. Hit enter. And because this is a native plugin, we have to do npx cap sync. All right. And basically what this will do is, you know, it will sync the plugin to the, you know, the native code. So for example, right now we have iOS. So, you know, you can see found one Capacitor plugin for iOS and this, right? And basically now it is synced with our project. Now, in order to make camera work with our app in iOS, we have to add some permissions. So for example, in iOS, if you go into the app and info plist, you can see we have like a bunch of information here, and we have to add more information that, you know, we want to use the camera app and all that. And I have it here, so I'm just going to copy and paste it. You can have a look at this in the source code that I'll be sharing in the description. So I'll push everything you're seeing here into a GitHub repo, and you can have access to that. Right? So basically, we need NS camera user description, why we want to use the camera, and then photo library users description. And one more permission we need is NS photo library add users description. So let's see if this works. Again, you know, I'm going to sync, because, you know, we are making changes to the native code. And then I'm going to go inside the Xcode. So let's open Xcode again and build this again, right? So I click on run, it's building, try to install it. Let's see if we are able to access our camera. But again, you know, in order to access our camera, we have to add a button, which will be, you know, calling the camera app, right? So we have installed this capacitor camera, right? So we are just going to import camera and camera, let's see, from add capacitor camera, right? So camera and camera result type. Okay, great. Now, as you can see, we have the state variable, and this is where we are going to store our image and show our image. And in order to show our image, I'll just add an EMG tag. So before the note list, I'm just going to say if there is an image, and show an IMG tag with source as the image, right? Now let's actually create the function which will call the camera. So let's go here, const take photo equal to async, because camera function is going to be, you know, async. So const photo equal to await camera dot get photo, right? And here we have to provide some configuration. So first is quality, and quality will just keep 90. You can, you know, if you want, you can keep it 100 or lower than that, right? Then we'll do allow editing to false. We don't want to, you know, them to edit it. And then at last we'll just do result type, which will be camera result type dot data URL, because the image that we need should be in data URL, so we'll be able to show that inside our image tag, right? So we'll get this photo, and then we'll just do set image photo dot data URL. All right, and if it's not there, then, you know, empty. And we need to create a button to call this function. I'm just going to go here and just copy this button, remove its width and height, give it more padding, let's say. And instead of plus, I'll just say take a photo, and also move it to the left. So let's left. And you can see, you know, move to the left. And then on click of it, I will call take photo, right? Which will call our native module. So take photo. So keep in mind that you are inside your web app, and you are able to access, you know, camera in the native app, right? So let's go to Xcode and rebuild the app. You don't have to sync the app right now, because the only changes you made is actually in the, you know, in your JavaScript code. So I'm just gonna click on take a photo, And you can see, you know, it basically shown me this model where from which I can, you know, choose the photo. I can click on take picture, but I'll not be able to, you know, take a picture because I'm in a simulator. So I'm just going to say from photos, and I will click on this photo, and you can see, you know, the image appeared, right? And it was able to pass that information from user file system to our web app, right? And this is how basically you will convert your web app into a mobile app. Also, you know, this is how using Capacitor plugins, you will be able to access native functionality right within from your web app. Again, you know, keep in mind that you can put any URL here. So for example, if your web, like, you know, on production, your website is on, like, you know, notes.com, you can just put notes.com here, and it will still be able to access all of the, you know, native modules from within the mobile app. So yeah, that's pretty much it. And I hope you like the video. I'll see you in the next one.